have a started variable, right? So we can see there are two types of the variable. One is your reference type and then your primitive type. And that reference type is also divided and primitive type is also divided. So reference type means the variable which is created by the class object, right? That is called referenced variable. We can hold an object. And primitive type variable means we have a static, we have a non-static, we have a local variable. So last session we have discussed. So we have some important point regarding that variable. So and this is like very important topic. Okay, so first I will go through this example, then it will you can understand easily. Okay, so important rule. So in a static method, so right now we are in a static method, right? Just I am going to comment this. So now we are in the static method. So in a static method, we have a class level variable, right? Static and non-static. And inside this static method or any method or any block, the variable which is created, that is called local variable. So we are going to differentiate as a class level variable and local variable. So you can see the name of class level variable and local variable is same. Then how to differentiate this? So this thing we are going to learn. So where we are going to differentiate? Inside this static method. Inside this static method, we have a variable that is called local variable. So how to differentiate this? Got it right? If I will, because we need to call this method m2, right? So just okay. So m2 method is your static method. So we can call directly. There is no need to create an object. We can call directly a static method, right? So what the output will come? You know, this output will come here 1000 and 2000, right? Okay, so if I will compile this code, I'm getting 1000 and 2000, but I need to access this variable. Then how to access? Or if you want to differentiate this variable, because the variable name is same, right? X and Y. So how to differentiate? So here we have some point here. In a static method, to differentiate a static variable with local variable. So static variable means class level variable, because there is no static variable inside this local variable, right? So we are going to differentiate. If you want to differentiate a static variable with local variable, okay, then how to differentiate this with local variable? We use class name, and you can also use class object, means referenced variable. So how to differentiate with a static variable with local variable? We can use either class name, or we can use, so I'm going to use here class name, right? So by using this class name, we can differentiate. Or if you want to access the variable which is having the same variable name in a local variable, the local variable which is created inside this static method, we also need to concentrate on this point also. So So this local variable which is created inside this static method. So this point I have written here, you can see. In a static method we are going to differentiate local variable. So local variable or class level variable. So how to differentiate? So first this static variable we can differentiate by using the class name. Or if you want to access, if you have a this scenario, or if you want to access, then by using the class name, you can see now the output will come 20. Got it, right? Or we can use by object reference, or we can differentiate by object reference. Got it, right? See. So this is the one point I have covered. This to differentiate. Now I am going to differentiate with non-static variable. So before I differentiated with a static variable, now I am going to differentiate with non-static variable. So non-static variable we can differentiate by using the object referenced or referenced variable only. Got it, right? So if I will compile this, now we will get. Tell me you have any doubt regarding this code. If you want, I will explain one more time.
Yeah, Mohit, one small thing. See, we differentiated like by help of class name with the static variable,
yeah,
and object creation with the non-static variable.
Yeah.
And we have written here like a static void m2. This is one method, right?
Yeah.
Instead of static method, we are differentiating the local variable with the class variable.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
We are calling all the whatever we mentioned in the local variable, both the static and non-static, where we mentioned in the local variable, class variable, we are calling into the static method. Right?
Yes.
All of them are calling into the static method where we need to differentiate between, because here we have some static method, so differentiating with the local variable, the non-local variable,
mm-hmm,
in a static method.
Yes.
Am I right?
Yeah, correct.
Thank you.
Okay, so we are now in the static method. Now we can differentiate with non-static method. Okay, so next topic is inside this non-static, right? So how to differentiate with non-static inside this non-static method. So same, just little bit difference is there. Here one more thing, we have this keyword here. So here same, you can see. Okay, so will come on this point. So same thing, like this is your class level variable, and now we are going to differentiate inside this non-static method, this local variable, right? The variable which is created inside this non-static method. Now before we were in the static method. So how to differentiate? Just remove this, not required for that. So
now this int x 100 and int y 200 is these are static method variables, right?
Yeah.
Where we declare.
Sorry, I didn't get you.
See here in the non-static method,
mm-hmm,
what are mentioned is like int x 100 and int y 200.
Mm-hmm.
This been declared into the static method. In the M2, am I right?
Non-static method, yes. Okay, so these are the difference. Got it? Okay, so now if you will call this method, we need to call, right? So we use here object to access M1, and now what happened when class is loaded into the JVM, then it will object will created, then again will M1 method will get memory, then inside this object we are going to access through the referenced variable t1.m1, then control will come inside this method. So JVM compiler is now entering inside this method. So now inside this M1, we have a X and Y getting memory located. Then again here I have created this object, so now I'm not using this, so just going to print this. So what the output will come? 100 and 200 only. Okay, now going to differentiate with class level variable. Okay, so a static and non-static, then how to differentiate? Okay, so we have a X is your non-static variable. So non-static variable, if you want to differentiate with non-static variable, so we can use either this keyword or we can use this object reference. So by using here this keyword, so this keyword I will discuss in the coming session, what is this keyword. Okay, just here we need to remember, if you are differentiating inside this non-static method of local variable as a class level variable, which class level variable? Non-static. Then how to differentiate? We can use this keyword or we can use referenced variable. Okay, now we are getting 10 and 10. So now I am going to differentiate a static variable. So a static variable, by we can use either class name, or we can use by this keyword, or we can use by this also. Okay, so here we can differentiate with the three ways. Okay, got it right? So just repeat one. Okay, this example, how I am going to execute your, you know, line by line and read this my document. Okay, there it is. Okay, so I have written here to differentiate inside this non-static method. To differentiate a static variable with local variable, we use class name or this variable or any other object of that class also. Object of that class means that one, reference variable. To differentiate non-static variable with local variable, we use this keyword or any other object reference of that. Reference means reference variable, object reference means. So this is the your, you know, how to differentiate with local variable with class level variable. Okay, so one more thing is there, that is called coding standard. So in the real time we need to follow coding standard. So I don't know where I kept that notes. Yeah, this one. Okay, so this is, you know, coding standard in we need to follow in the real time, because why it is required? If you are writing the variable, if you are writing the method, if you are writing the class name, okay, then we need to follow. We cannot write anything as a real time if you are creating a project, because you are not only one person to working on in one project. We have a many people to working in the one project, or if you are working in, if you are working in your project, right, after 1 year you left the company, so that project is handling to the new resources. So if you are not following coding standard, what happened? Other people are not able to understand. So we need to follow coding standard. It is very important. Okay, so usually method name are either var or var noun combination. So when you are writing the method name, you can see it is starting from, you know, a small letter, right? But if you will start from the next word means it will start from your capital letter. Okay, like method name is your get only. So we have a method name is your get only, right? If you are like method is like get name or get salary, so you can see second word will start from, if it will come in the second word, next word, then again it will start from capital. If it will come in the next word, again it will start from the capital. Only first word will start from the small letter. Apart from that, if you are using any other word, it will start from capital letter. So this is very important in the real time. If you are working, we need to follow coding standard. You can see get information of employee. So method name should start with lowercase character, or if it is the it contains the multiple word and every inner word should start with upper character. Got it right? Same thing happen with variable also, you can see, but here we are not using parenthesis. That is a different one, right? If you are writing one variable name, that is a small start from. If you are starting from next word, it will start from capital. And you know, class name is also start from capital letter, right? So this need to follow. Okay, so same variable will also follow the same rules. Okay, so this is your, we have a next topic. I need to say this package, right? So package is nothing but a folder, right? I already shown you. So when you are installing the JDK and JRE, we have our packages. So these are the nothing but this is your folder. Okay, this is your folder. So package is nothing but it is a folder. Okay, these are the one package. Like I can show you, if you will go in the real time, I can show you. Okay.
Mohit.
Yes.
Before the session, we can have an. At the end of the session, we can have one like debugging. Like,
okay, I will tell you. I'll tell you. Okay. Yeah. Sure.
End up like not now at the end of the session.
Yeah. Sure. I'll tell you.
Thank you.
So these are the packages, right? So if you will go in the lang package. So here see, this is your lang package, right? Lang package, you can see these are the classes, interfaces are there. So if you will install the JDK and if you will extract that jar file, this is your, you know, folders. So package is nothing but it is a folder. Okay, now we have a inbuilt classes and all, right? Inside this you can see we have a many classes, right? This is your exception type, or you can see this is your class summary. So these are the many classes are there inside your this package, right? So we are using object class, right? So how to access this? Got it, right? So then we will go through the package concept. Okay, you need to access this. Inside this folder we have a variable, we have a class, we have a, you know, interface, we have a method. So how to access in your code, this thing we are going to learn. So the folder which is linked with the Java package is called package. It is used to separate a new classes from the existing classes. Okay, so if you have a new classes or existing classes, so it will be separate. Okay, it is used for the group related classes, interface, enum and annotation. So these are the types of the classes. So we will discuss these classes or interface classes we already use. Interface we did not use. Enum and annotation is a type of the class, but we are not going to discuss, not useful. So by using the package, we can create a multiple package with same name, and also we can create a user defined classes with predefined classes name. So import is a keyword, right? So import keyword is used to access other package member from this package. If you have something in the another package and you want to access that class in a different package, we'll use this import keyword. Okay, I'll show you in the Eclipse how it is working. It is not a big deal, just we need to remember, understand this how it is going, because in the Eclipse everything will come in your suggestion, and simply you can import this package, not a big deal. Okay, so import, so how to, we have a two syntax of import. So we have a import or package name or name. If you will use import or package name or dot star, then what happen, all the, you know, whatever the packages having the all the members it will be imported in your class. Dot star means it will import all the members which is available in the one package. Like this is your one package, lang package. So if you will use this import dot java dot lang dot star, all the whatever the things which is available inside this package, this is imported in your class, and according to the project requirement we can use all the classes. Okay, so this is your import package name. I want to access only one class which is available inside this package, so we can use simply import package name dot class name. Okay, so first syntax allow the compiler and JVM access all the public member like classes, interface, enum, annotation of that imported package, whereas again syntax allow compiler and JVM to access only that import class. So we have some rules. Import statement must be placed before all the class definition. These are the packages. See, right, import package name, right? So these are the packages is coming from in this is the package name org openq selenium keys, right? So it will come on your suggestion when you are writing. Here already packages are imported, so okay, we will see in the selenium, not a big deal. So leave it, just we need to understand little bit idea about of that, then we can see in the selenium, not a big deal. Okay, so import statement must be placed before and all class definition. To access package class, its member must be declared as a public or else it leads to a compile time error. So I have shown you, right, the accessibility modifier, what you can access: public, private, protected and default. So we need to also care, if you have a private, then you cannot access inside the another package, you can access only within the class only, right? If you are default, then we can access within the package only. If you want to access in all over the class, means in your project, then we will use public. Okay, so not a big deal. What is the benefits to get the using the import a statement over fully qualified name? Okay, so why we are using import? So if we do not use import a statement, we must use package name everywhere we are using the class name or constructor. This code is not readable or solve this problem, we have to we will use the import concept statement. We no need to use package name or referring the class name or its constructor. If we will not use, then what happen? It will come the ambiguity problem means compiler and JVM is not able to understand the class name, or when you are importing that classes which is having the same name, like one class is there and which is having the same name in the different classes, different package. One class in the package one, another class in the package two, and both classes having the same name. So JVM and compiler will confuse, right? So that is called ambiguity problem, because of more than one import package having the class with the same name, right? So this is not related to package, just I have this example is object class and simple class, object type of an array and simple class, and are storing this value. So this object is already imported, right? So we have a one example. Okay, so if you will, you can say I'm not importing now this. So what happened, just I going to explain this code. So this is your class string demo. Here we have created one scanner class object. So scanner is a class which is available in util package. This is an util package, it is in util package, right? So this is available in util package. So I have created, this is your inbuilt class, so created an object and passing this parameter argument system dot in. So what is the job of this system.in, it will take the input from the system. Okay, so a scanner class, you go in the scanner class. Okay, so see, this is your scanner class. So a scanner class, which is available in the util package. Okay, so it's a simple text scanner with primitive type or a string type. So you can check this code is already they have created, right? This code allow to use to read the number from the system.in. So system.in means it is taking from the input from your system, right? So this is your scanner class. They already, you know, given, and inside this we have a many methods. You can see this is the constructor and these are the method which is present inside this scanner class. So if you have any doubt regarding any inbuilt classes or method, just go through the official documentation. You can understand easily. Even in your real time, if you are working, the thing which doesn't know and they are using, right? So just go in the official documentation and read it, what is the use of that, okay? But in Eclipse, if you will mouse over that will come, you know, suggestion, it will come the, you know, all the details, okay? So that's why we are using this scanner class. Here printing this value, system.out.println, enter your name. Then inside this we have a method called next line. So what is the use of next line? It will go the cursor from the next line. Name itself is next line, right? So it will go in the, again I'm going to printing, do you have a name? Again it will go in the next line cursor. So here we have a else condition. So s1 dot equal ignore case no. If you this condition will pass, then this message will display. If it won't be passed, then this message will display. If I will compile this, now we are getting error. You know, this scanner class is coming from util package, but this scanner class we did not import in our class, so that's why it is showing cannot find the symbol. So that's why we need to import this. So how to import java.util, util.star. Here your java.util is your package name, and dot star means it will be access all the member which is inside in util package. Okay, so now if I will execute, okay, so enter your name. Okay, so now you can see the cursor is coming in the next line. Why, how it is coming? Because of your next line method. Got it, right? If so, enter your name, it will execute again. The I enter my name, input, system is taking the input or user is giving the input. I have given the input mk, then again this line will execute, right? This line is executed. Do you have a name? It is printing the message. Then again you can see the cursor is going in the next line, it's blinking. So this line is executed. Okay, now it is asking, give me the input, whatever the input you want to tell. So I am giving the input no. Then what happened? This block will execute. You are great. Got it, right? So again I will execute this one more time. Close this. Okay, so do you enter your name? Okay, mk. Do you have a name? If I will press yes, then what happened? This block won't be executed, then else block will execute. Got it, right? So this is a simple example regarding the package. So next topic is your static member and its execution flow. So what is the static member, right? And what is the static keyword? So static keyword, right? Static and non-static, we already discussed regarding this. Like if you have a one application, you can take any application, like we are going to take string bank name, okay, bank name, okay, just I'm going to take this bank name string, or okay, so IFSC, okay, just IFSC code, okay, right. So when you are going to develop any application, so this is your bank name or IFSC code, I cannot change this, or this is the common for all the customer which is having inside this bank. Like bank name is your HDFC, right? Inside this HDFC we have a more than 1 lakh or customer or 10 lakh customer using this bank. So these are the customer, okay. So this 1 lakh customer having the same branch, right? So we have a same branch. So what we needed to the customer details, right? Name, okay, mobile number, or PAN card number. These are the customer details. So if you are using a here I am going to use here a static name is a static, mobile means customer information I am going to use as a static. Then one of the customer want to change the mobile number, then what happen if he will use the static? It will affect to the all the customer data. If you change this, then what happen? It will affect to this guy also. Means 10 lakh customer, it will impact on the data, because for the static we have a common copy of memory, got it, right? But bank name is common to all the customers, so no need to change the bank name, right? So here we will use a static, here we will use non-static. Non-static means we have a specific copy of memory. This customer having the specific copy of memory. This is your own transport, right? And this is your public transport. Public is common. Your own transport, you can use yourself, right? So every customer having the specific copy of memory. So if you have a requirement to the specific copy, internal data will be used for the specific person or a specific user, then we should go for non-static. If you have a single copy of memory, we will use for the common for all the customer or all the user, then we should go for a static. I think you got idea. So JVM, so what happened, the JVM people have provided, when JVM, right, loaded, or when class is loaded into the JVM, that time this all the member will get memory, a static member, because this is the common memory for all. So that's why at that time they have provided the memory for the static. But non-static, we have a specific copy, then they think how we can provide the specific memory, then they have provided the concept of object. We need to create an object, how many, you know, many types of the object, many object will create, that many memory will created inside. This is JVM, okay. So from where you can use as a project level, right? So if you have a common thing, then we should go for a static, right? If you have a specific, then we should go for non-static members. So we are learning a static and non-static members. Static. Okay. A static test. Okay, so we have static variable. Okay, this is the one member of a static. We have a static block. This is your another member of a static member. Okay, this is your static block. Okay, and we have a static method. This is the another member of a static method, and we have a one more member, m1 static m1. We have another member of a static that is called main method. So these are the static member. Got it, right? So here this is your main. Okay, so now if I will compile this code, what the output will come? If you already attend my session, you guys will give the answers. If I will compile this code, what the output will come?
Compile time error, like when we call in main method, we should mm-hmm. call it by help of a class member.
Mm-hmm. Okay, no problem. If you will speak in my session, your offer will come first. Yeah, this is the proof. It doesn't matter your answer is wrong or right, because I can understand where are you not understanding, right? If you are silent, how I can understand what you are not understanding?
Exactly.
Right? So that way I can explain. So I'm expecting if you don't know anything, you can also give the answer. You know, luck by, if it will good, that is fine. But here you cannot lose anything, you will gain, right? So this is your static variable and this is your static block, and this is your static method, and this is your main method. So if I will compile this code, you can see what the output will come. I am able to compile, no compile time error, and I will able to execute. So here you can see before main method, you know, a static block is executed. Okay, before main method, a static block will execute, but before a static block, a static variable is also executed. So what is the conclusion of this static control flow? Before main method, two members is executing. Okay, before main method, two members will execute. So before we were learning, when class is loaded into the JVM, then JVM and compiler will look main method. Okay, but main method is also look before a static block or a static variable is there or not. JVM is looking for main method, but main method is also looking for before a static block or a static variable is there or not. When before main method, if a static block will be there or a static variable will be there, then a static block or a static variable will be executed. Okay, so I am telling you here, I will create one more static. I am telling you, like, before main method, a static block or a static variable will execute. So we can see a static block we are able to see, but how I can prove before main method a static block or a static variable will execute. So now need to prove this. Before main method, we have why the people are getting placed in my session, because of Java. Selenium you can play yourself. And if you will go in the interview, 80% question, they can check your Java concept. If you are good in Java, you can play with Selenium. But in automation testing profile, they are not focusing on the Java concept. You can see, if you will go in the tutorial also, YouTube tutorial, or they are discussing basics Java. If you are the first time learning the Java, many confusion will come. Okay, so now we are going to do, okay, what I want going to prove before main method, I want to execute a static block or a static variable. So now you can see I have created one method, m1 is already there, so I am going to create m2. M1 is already there, I am going to create m2. Now you can see this is your variable, right? Inside this variable we can store this one. Okay, just any compile time error? No, right? Got it, right? Inside this 10 variable, actually that line of the code is executing, but we are not able to see it is executing properly or not. So here we are learning two important question, but nobody will ask this question. You can ask to developer in your company, developer is there, right? You can ask to developer. Okay, so here I store this m2. Okay, so what happened here, how this code will work? Class loaded into the JVM. JVM is looking for the main method. If it is there, then main method will look before a static block or a static variable is there or not. If it is there, then we have the order, we have also order with a static variable and a static block. What the order is there? If you will create a static variable first, then a static variable will execute. If you will create a static block first, then a static block will execute. So this two things is variable, and it is executing according to the order, which order you have created. Got it, right? So what happened, we have a static variable, then control will go here, then it will execute. This line will execute, then it will search where is m2, then what happened, m2 will execute. This is the one more question. Without calling the method, how to execute the method? Because we have learned without calling method we cannot execute, but here we have a two concept with one step, right? So here without calling the method we can also execute, but don't care about of that, just we need to concentrate on the concept. So this is your static variable. So now if I will compile this code, you can see now it is executing a static variable, a static block and main method. So from today onwards, before main method, it is executing a static variable and a static block than main method. This type of the question they can ask in your product based company, in the written test or face to face. They will give you the code and they will tell you, can you find the output? Okay, so service based, they knows only a static block, they will not reach on the static variable. But product based, they will reach on the complete flow. Okay, so now got it this point. If you are still you have a doubt, I will explain one more time.
Yeah, Mohit, can you please explain one more time?
Okay, so see, so this is your one class. Okay, so we have a main method. So main method, we are discussing about a static member, right? So we have a clear idea about where we can use a static or where we can use non-static. So in a static we have a members. If I will tell the static members, it will come your static variable, a static block, and method or main method, a static method or main method, right? So how it is going to execute? So when we are using this, when you are executing this, then JVM and compiler will look like the main method. So main method is there, means our code as a runtime, I won't be get any error. Okay, because main method is there, right? I discuss why main method is required. If you will create a user defined method, then what will happen? Got it? But before main method, we have a two member, that is called a static member, a static block and a static variable. So here I did not do anything. Okay, here simply I have created one variable. Right, here I have created one variable, and I am telling you ki before main method it will execute a static variable or a static block. When I was using this, it is executing, but it is not showing the result internally executed. So how we can prove that? What I did, I have created one method, and this method I store inside this variable. Got it, right? This method I store inside this variable. I can not, if I will copy this code here, I don't know, it will, let's see, it will copy it or not. Okay, it won't copy it all. Okay, so no problem. So what happened? I cannot explain it. So let's go here only. I don't have this, you know, marker to explain that, but I will tell you. Okay, got it, right? So in place of a 10, right, what I store here? M2, and which type it is? Integer type. So it is, we will not getting any incompatibility stuff, right? So how it will execute? When class is loaded into the JVM, then compiler and JVM will look like main method is there or not. That control will come here. Main method is there, but before main method it will check, then compiler will go, it will check, okay, this is your method is there, but it will check first, it will go in the top level. In the top level it will check from top to bottom. Okay, it will check a static variable is there or not. Yes, a static variable is there. Then this line is executed. When this line will execute, control will come. Then this we have a M2. Then it will search where is M2. Then again M2 here. Then this block will execute. Then again it will execute what? A static block. Right. If you will call this method, then again control will come inside this main method, right? Because you can see after executing a static variable and a static block, control will come in the main method, because the main method will execute after that. If you will call here the method, this method, a static method, then a static method will execute. Tell me where you are not able to understand. Okay, which line you are not able to understand?
I got it now.
Got it?
I am clear for now.
Okay, so this method will execute this method when you will called, right? If I am calling this method here, then it will execute after main, because the method is executing from sequential order, right? So then what happened? Control will come here, then main is executing this print. A statement executed, then it will execute. You can see now. Okay, a static variable, a static block, main and a static method. And if I will call here, then it will execute here only, because the method is executing from top to bottom. The print statement will execute after that. You can see a static method will come and a static, right? So it depend upon in which order you are calling. This is the one thing. if I will create this static block before a static variable, then it will execute first a static block. Got it, right? So these are the order depend upon, we need to check, okay, which one it is there first. If a static block is there first, then a static block execute. If a static variable is there, then a static variable will execute. It totally depend upon in which order you are going to create this. Okay, so order, yes
static block and static method is different, right?
This is the different
static method and static block is different, right?
Yes.
Okay.
So now, just I have documented a static member and its execution flow. The class level member which has a static keyword in its definition is called a static member. So types of the static member: a static variable, a static block, a static method, and main method. So when and where and how and by whom memory located provided by the static variable. So when class is loaded into the JVM, provide the individual a single copy of memory location to each static variable in method area. So in JVM we have a area, like we have a method area, we have a heap area. So in method area, this static variable get memory only in a class lifetime. Class lifetime means until your class will be there, that time, you know, that is the lifetime of that static variable memory. Okay, so what is the lifetime and a scope of the static variable? So a static variable get life as soon as possible class is loaded into the JVM and is available till class is removed from the JVM. Okay, and JVM is shut down. Until unless the memory is there, your JVM is there or your class is there. Okay, its a scope is class. A scope means it is accessible through the class directly by its name and outside the class by its class name provided into JVM, but it is a not a private, right? So same thing I have discussed here, you can access directly, it should not be a private, right? We can say, right, a static variable we can access another where also. So what is the a static block? Is a class level block that contains the static keyword and its creation statement. It execute some logic at a time of class loading. Actually, if you will go in the real time development of the code, some of the logic must be executed before main method. So that logic we will create inside this a static block. Okay, but only once. It will execute only once. It won't be executed again and again. Okay, so it is used for initializing the static variable. So sometime they initialize the static variable inside this static block. Okay, creation syntax. So this thing we can static stuff we can use as a, you know, import keyword also with respect to, but you can see very less this stuff. So sometimes the people are using for requirement. So this is your static variable, this is your static block, this is your static method, and this is your main method. And one more member is there, that is called a static inner a static class, but we are not going through that. Okay, no, not required for that, but leave it. But core member we need to know that. Okay, so JVM activity. So what is the JVM activity? When we run a class using Java command, JVM load and store given bytecode inside this method area or a stack area using this java.lang. So all the member, static member, will get memory inside this method area. So in JVM, having, you can see, you know, JVM is a, like a big memory, and they have also divided, you know, every member where this member will store. Like a static member will store inside this method area. The JVM start class execution by running the static member like a static variable, a static block, and main method. So JVM execute first a static variable and a static block in its main. It will execute what? Main method. So JVM execute a static variable, a static block in the order they are defined top to bottom, right? So it will execute a static variable, a static block in the order they are defined. It will create a static block will come first, then a static block will execute. If a static variable will come first, then a static variable will execute. This is your memory location. A static member flow, memory allocated, first memory will allocate, then it will initialize, then it will execute, right? First we will get the memory, then initialization, then execution, right? So here we have a static variable. So just I have given some like how it is going to getting the memory allocation or initialization. So this is your static variable, memory allocated, a static variable to memory allocated, then it will initialized, okay? Then after initializing, this static block will get the memory, then again a static block will get memory, okay? So I can show you in the example so you will get more clarity. Before we were discussing about in one class, but here we will use two classes, right? We will use inheritance concept. Okay, so we have a static variable. So these are the order like it will execute, right? You can see this order like one variable one, then again variable two, then again this will initialize. After allocating the memory, it will initialize. Then fourth point, after that this block will get initialized, then again this block will get initialized, then again it will execute, then this is your main method will execute, then this is your static method will execute. Okay, so with respect to diagram, so in the diagram JVM will provide the memory for all static variable from top to bottom with default value based on the data type. Check the point 1 and 2. So check the point, whatever the point 1 and 2 just I have discussed. Then a static variable assignment and a static block logic execute in order they are defined from top to bottom. Check the point 3, 4, 5 and 6. Okay, so you can check this point and you can read one more time. Okay, finally main method is executed. Then static method are executed only when they are called. If you won't call, then it won't be executed. Okay, so you know inheritance concept. Who is learning first time Java? So what is the inheritance concept? Why we use inheritance concept in Java? If you are using this inheritance concept, then how to use this?
Using extends keyword.
Okay.
We can use properties of one class to another class.
Okay. What is your name?
Anil.
Okay, Anil. Good. But my question is, why we use? If I will not use, what the problem we will face?
It's reusability.
Okay.
And every time we no need to create new variables and all. Once we create whenever we are using regular methods, frequent using methods and variables, at the time we can make it as a parent class and we can create a child class.
Okay. Yeah. So you know, if you will go as a project level, so we have a many classes. This one, right? You can see if you will go in the project inside this project, we have a many packages and many classes, right? Many packages and many classes. I don't think so I use somewhere or not. Okay, just will understand this. So these are the, you know, many classes are there in one class. What is this one class? We have a, inside this class we have a members, right? Your variable or your method, right? These are the members, blocks, right? Main method, these are the members. This is called properties or behavior. So what happened? We have a multiple classes and that classes, you know, properties or behavior means all the members, if you want to use in the another class. So So what we can do, we can provide the relationship between the one class to another class. Got it, right? So how to provide the relationship in Java? We will use extend keyword. You can see here, this is your class, one class, and this is your another class. This is called your super class or parent class. This is called your child class or subclass. So when we are using extend keyword, then what happen? All the things which is available inside this class test, we can, if I will execute this class test one, it all the properties and behavior they acquired, they have, or we can say we have a relationship between the one classes to another classes. So I can only execute this, then it will also execute, means you are able to access in this class, you are able to access test class one member also. Got it, right? So here I will also explain how inheritance is working, okay, in the coming session. Execution flow, how when code is, when you are using extend keyword, how the control is reaching from one class to another class. Okay, so I will discuss this. Got it? So here just, you know, we have our two classes, test and test one, and here just we are calling this method one and method two. Okay, so just if you will, what happen when class is loaded into the JVM, then it will get memory, this memory created, and going to access M1, then it will search where is M1. You can see in, it will search in this class, M1 is there or not. No, M1 is not there. If you don't have a relation, then it won't be searched in M2. Because of this, it will go in the class test. This is your M1. Then this M1 will execute. Again, control will back. Then again, it will search to M2. Where is your M2? Again, the control will go inside this. Yeah, M2 is there. Then M2 will execute. Got it, right? So this is your inheritance by using with respect to extend keyword. Okay, so here one code is there. Why I have discussed this? Because of this code I am using inheritance concept. Okay, I think I use in this program or not. Yeah, I have. So here you can see with respect to, we have a two classes, same thing whatever we have discussed, two example. This is related, just we are going to enhance that code, that's it, adding the more members on that. So we have a class one, right? This test 1 3. Inside this we have a static variable, then a static block, then we have a static subclass and extending this. Again we have a static variable, a static block, and we have a main method, and we have a one more method that is called M1 method. So I will come on that before that. Okay, now how it will execute a static control flow and instant control flow with respect to inheritance. So how it will execute? When class is loaded into the JVM, when subclass, right? So what is your subclass? This class I saved, right? See, test12.java. So when class is loaded into the JVM, then what will happen? JVM identify, first it will identify, JVM is identify a static variable, a static block, a static method and main method from super class to subclass in the order they are defined top to bottom. How it will identify from super class to subclass in the order they are defined? First it will identify, okay, it will go in the super class, then identification of a static variable, a static block, again identification of a static variable, a static block, right? So first it will identify, then it will execute a static variable, a static block from superclass to subclass in the order they are defined, right? It will execute from superclass to subclass. In which order you have created, that order it will execute. Then finally, it execute main method from current loaded subclass. If it does not contain main method, then JVM execute main method from superclass. If main method is not there here, then it will search in the superclass. Still it is not there, again it will search to the next class, next to object class. Still not able to find the JVM, it will throw the error. Got it, right? So main method must be there. If not found, then JVM will throw error. So JVM execute the in the last JVM execute called a static method from current loaded subclass. Okay, so if I will execute this code, I will show you the output, then you guys are able to understand. You can see now superclass a static block is executed, subclass a static block executed, main method executed, then a static method is executed, right? So identification done, then superclass to subclass, then control will executed this, but here it is executed, but it is not showing the output because I did not store any other thing, right? Any method here. Then it will execute this, then control will back again. It will I'm not executing with respect to variable, right? If we will use with respect to variable, then it will execute first, then control will come inside this, then it is executed a static block. You can see a static block, then main method, then a static method. Okay, so just do the practice from three code, whatever the code I have discussed, then you will get more clarity. If today you will not revise the thing, I have one more code, you are not able to understand. Okay, so today topic is very important. So revise one, so this code will again explain tomorrow example two. You will understand this code, then you are good in the static control flow. Okay, so I am stopping the session. The people who want to leave, you can leave. So he was telling how to debug the code. Okay, actually in the Selenium library I have facing some problem in my Eclipse in the setting, but with respect to Java I will tell you how to do that. So we have any Java practice? Yeah, anything? Yeah, okay. Like I am going to this, I want to debug this code, right? So first we need to where you can debug, when the execution is started, right? So here execution is started, this is your main method. So you have to put here debug point. How to put here? If you will click on the double click here, double click here, I think something, yeah, okay. Okay, I put it. You can see this is your debug point. If you will double click, this debug point will come. Okay, when you are where, like why we are using the debugging? If your method is going to fail, okay, so what happened? The code will execute from where and it will break here. Okay, so now what you can do? You can go and debug as. You will press debug as. So if you will press yes, then it will come in the another window, but I don't want to go, simply I want no. Okay, then you can see here now we have a control here, right? So here we have a, you can see we have a step into and a step over. So a step into means, you can see we have a also shortcut F5 or F6. So a step into means it will go inside to inside method. Like if I will press a step 5, then it will go in the, you know, this it will also execute array list in which package it is, util package, then it will go in the inbuilt library. But if you want to go in the step over, then just will press a step 6. okay, then control is going here, okay, right? If you will press control 6, the control is going down. If I will press control 5, then it will go inside this method also. Got it, right? If you will press control 5, it will go inside this method, but I don't want. You can see, if you will go mouse over, you can see this is the variable it is showing. Whatever the I value is 0, like that you can debug this. So if I will go in the control 6, okay, control 6, now it loops will execute until, you know, value you are storing. I don't know why this pop-up is coming. Launch configuration debug. Okay, right, so this will execute, okay, till I have to check this, why this pop-up is coming. Okay, a step over means if you will press, now that loop is over, this value is stored here. How many times loop is executed, you know, how many value it is there inside this. So again I am going to a step 6, just I am pressing this a step 6, right? So it will execute like that. Okay, if you want to learn more, just go through any videos of there inside this debug, then you can get it. Okay, just